Get ready to match the star. Joey Bishop, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Lynn Deerfield, Richard Dawson, and Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Reimer.
Thank you, Johnny Olson and friends. Got a very lively bunch there, and I hope you're a lively bunch at home, too, because we've got a lively bunch here on this stage. What are you doing, Joey?
It's my kind of crowd. They slept overnight in the studio. Beautiful.
Yes.
I love them.
They're very refreshed and eager and ready to go. Shall we all have a go at it?
Yes.
Okay.
Can we do the show first?
Oh, sure. Okay, let's do the show first. Oh, you rascal. There's our current champ, Muriel Zlotnikoff, there. Zlotnikoff. Yay, Muriel. Now, Muriel, you've won a game, haven't you?
Yes.
And now you're going to try for the big money.
That's right.
How do you feel about that?
Great. Super.
You feel super?
Super, yes.
Okay, you look super. You're okay, Muriel. She's going to try for over $5,000. So you hurry back after this message and see how she does here, okay? Okay. Here we are. They get Ira on camera? No, I guess they didn't. Get him on camera, Mark?
You bet.
Ira, we got you on camera. Okay, you ready?
Yes.
Yes. You ever been in show business?
No. I know someone in show business, though.
Who?
I used to be president of the Eddie Fisher fan club.
No kidding.
Yes, it's from my hometown, Philadelphia.
Yep.
Casey's watching. Hi there, Eddie.
You can't do that. I told you you can't do that.
Sorry.
You are you still president of the Eddie Fisher fan club?
No. It's Robert Redford, remember?
Oh, yes. Now you're president of the Robert Redford fan club?
No, but I will be soon, I hope. Call me Robert. Say yes.
Listen, you don't need me. You don't need the money. Does that work when you're that direct like that?
No, it scares everybody away.
Oh. All right. Well, let's see how you do here.
Explain why we haven't heard from Eddie Fisher for quite a long
time. That's right. What's he doing now?
Who, Eddie?
Yeah.
Janet, last I heard he was in London with Catherine Deneuve.
Oh,
she's not
okay.
Bad.
I'm so thrilled. What? I'm so thrilled to be here on Tattletales.
Okay, here we go. Muriel, we polled a recent studio audience and we got their best response to this. So are blank. Now, the answer that group gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it now. Now, if you match that middle one, you get $250, and then the bottom one gets you $100. Three of our six celebrities will help you out here by giving you some answers now. You may call them one at a time.
Richard.
Sore loser.
Sore loser is one.
Uh-huh. Betty.
Sore throat.
Sore throat.
I like that one. And Charles.
She doesn't say that like she says Robert Redford.
No.
Sorry.
No reason why she should.
Sore head.
Sore head. Sore head, sore loser, and sore throat are the three. Now, you can choose one of those. Have you got any other ideas that you want to think are better?
No. I'm going to go with sore loser.
Sore loser. That's Richard's answer.
Well, let's see how it turns out.
Audience,
they're groaning at her.
Yeah, they're groaning at her. They think that's not the right. You don't think that's going to be up on top? What do you think? Sore throat?
Yeah.
All right, we'll find out right now. The moment of truth is at hand. Let us reveal the $100 response. Sore head. Okay, we're looking for sore loser. May we see the $250 number? Sore loser. Congratulations, you got $250 more. Yeah. Now, according to the audience here in the studio at this moment, they say sore throat is going to be the big one. Okay, Peter, let's see it. Sore throat again.
I was going to say throat.
Why didn't you?
I don't know. I was going to say loser, too. Can't say both of them.
No, you can't say. You just had to say one.
Right.
All right. Well, listen, you won the $250. You got a total of $350 now. You're going to play for 10 times that amount or $2,500.
Okay.
Which one celebrity would you like to try to match, get some ESP going with, and collect that money?
I'll take Richard.
Okay. stand on the adhesive tape, and try and remain reasonably still. If you can, it would be helpful. You ready, Richard?
Yeah, ready, sir.
Are you thinking about Richard?
Yes.
She's thinking about Robert Redford, isn't
she? Oh, yes, she's thinking about Robert
Already
Redford.
Already established
but
that.
Get some ESP going over to Richard. Here it is. Table blank. T-A-B-L-E. Table blank. Finished. Now, what answer would you give us?
Cloth.
That'll match. What's that?
Tablecloth.
Tablecloth. Tablecloth.
Tablecloth.
Tablecloth.
Table
you think that'll match it?
Oh, gosh, yes. I'm so...
Do you have anything else in your mind?
No.
I couldn't think of anything else.
Yes, I thought of tableware, but tablecloth came first.
Okay, tablecloth says we'll match it for $2,500, Richard. What do you say to that?
I'm having a very bad time this week. I said cloth. Ah!
Now, you got $2,850. How about that?
That's not bad.
That's not bad at all. Okay. Are you ready to carry on?
Yes, let's go.
All right, let's meet your new competitor here now. Here comes Al Walker. Let's go. All right, choose your step. You can get back on. Don't hurt yourself there. Hello, Al.
Gene.
How are you?
Fine, and you?
Good, I'm all right. Thank you for asking. Where are you from?
From New Orleans, Louisiana.
Yeah. Got a lot of Louisianans here, huh? Right on there. What do you do?
I'm a body and fender man, Gene, and I won't tell you the name of the place, but it's located at...
You're a body and fender man.
That's right.
He doesn't have a bad body at all, does he?
No. Alan's an ankle.
Yes, his fenders are okay, too, aren't they? That's hard work, isn't it?
Very hard work.
But it's kind of creative, isn't it? You mix the colors and do all that, or you just do the banging on the fenders?
Just mostly the banging.
I see.
But I do have other interests.
Well, if you work all day, how do you get a chance to see this show?
Well, I don't get the chance to see as much as I used to before I was doing body and fenders, so I'm taking up a trade electronics course, and I'm looking forward to getting my certificate so that I can arrange my hours so that I can see Match Game every day.
Attaboy.
Good for you.
Anything else you want to tell us?
Well, yes, I have other interests, and that is the Bible, and I like...
He's interested in the Bible.
That's and it. I like music in that order.
What kind of music? Pop music?
Any kind of music,
any
as
kind.
Long as it's within
right.
reason.
Okay, Al. Listen, we got to stop right now for a second or two, do a little business with America. You hurry right back and see what happens next. One. Here, I am one, and I'm ready to go there. Oops. Oh, there it is, A or B. Al, you can have a choice here, A or B.
B for Al.
B for Al. I tell you.
You and I are going to end up over there.
We're going to end. You're right. We're going to end up over there. That's all right. You ready now?
The Al and Muriel show.
Yes.
And I'm not pleased.
Say, did you hear that Donald the doctor married Laura the lawyer? You didn't hear? Well, let me tell you, it's a terrible union. Every time he blanks her, she sues him for malpractice.
Now, he's a doctor, right?
He's a doctor, she's a lawyer. And it's a terrible situation. Every time he blanks her, she sues him for malpractice.
I got it.
All right. These two are ready. Okay. They're married, you see. Donald the doctor and Laura the lawyer. They are married to each other.
I heard that, yeah.
And every time he blanks her, she sues him for malpractice.
He's a doctor.
He's a doctor. She's a lawyer.
He's a lawyer.
Yeah.
And every time he blanks
her? Every time he blanks her, she sues him for malpractice.
Laura the doctor and Donald the lawyer.
This lady is on CBS, too.
Guiding Light.
She's on Guiding Light. One of the most successful soap operas of all time. It's been on for a long time, hasn't it?
About 37 years in broadcasting, counting radio.
Really?
Yes.
Isn't
and I was one of your regulars then.
You were one of the regulars 37 years ago.
No.
She'd been to Shangri-La and back. Okay, here we go, Al Walker. Donald the doctor married lawyer Laura the lawyer, and it's terrible. Every time he blanks her, she sues him for malpractice. Makes love with her. I think that's a very good answer. Every time he makes love with her, she sues him for malpractice.
Will you count the one I threw away?
Oh, did you have
I that? Had makes love, yeah. Oh. Then I thought, well...
What?
Then I thought, every time he examines her.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but
he's a doctor. Well, makes love is a good kind of a little joke there. What do you say, Brett?
I think I need a month in the country, Miss Moon.
Okay.
This is not my week. I said examines.
Examines. Well, that's what you'd expect a doctor to do, but that would be the pedestrian answer that we were not seeking, Charles.
Oh. I want to hear that loud New Orleans yell.
Makes love. Every time he makes love with her, she sues him for malpractice. What do you say to that?
Makes love, too.
Makes love. That's two for Al Walker. Al Walker's living with a little love.
Well, you've come to the right place.
He's just a regular doctor.
A regular doctor.
Because if he were a surgeon, she'd say, cut that out. And he would.
Yes, he would.
But makes love.
Makes love. He's off to a good start. That happened to you once, didn't it? You got five in your first round. You ready, Muriel? Here it is. When Weird Willie went to the restaurant.
Oh, Weird Willie again, eh?
He brought along a huge doggy bag. And at the end of the meal, he tried to put the blank in it.
How huge was it? Okay.
Big doggy bag.
He went to a restaurant, right, sweetheart?
Right. Went to a restaurant, brought along a huge doggy bag. At the end of the meal, he tried to put the blank in it. Ready, Charles? Haven't even started, Charles, have you? Oh, Charles.
Clever little answer there.
All right. Here we go. Muriel, when Weird Willie went to the restaurant, he brought along a huge doggy bag. And at the end of the meal, he tried to put the blank in it.
I'll say waiter.
Waiter's good. Waiter's good. Little lady came up with a pretty good answer.
Trying to figure out this game, I said he made love to the bag.
He made love to the bag.
No. I'm trying to get into the feel of this somehow.
So far, it's not working.
I said, the question was, right?
A huge doggy bag. At the end of the meal, he tried to put the...
The dog in the
put
bag.
Put the dog in the doggy bag.
What dog?
Where is that? I never said anything about a dog. He brought along a doggy bag. What'd you say?
I thought the doggy was home.
Yeah, that's what I thought, too.
Me, too, because I said waiter.
Waiter's good. Charles?
I said table.
Table. Trying to put the table in the doggy bag. So far, scores 4-1. Hello there, Lynn Deerfield.
I had table and threw it out, and I have dog, and I should throw it out.
Okay, throw it out. All right. Ruff, ruff.
See?
Looking for a waiter.
Waiter.
Got found a waiter there. 4-2 to score.
This is not my table. Waiter.
Okay. So the score is 4-3, and that's the end of round one, and now we've got this message for you. Round one has come and gone. I will push the button, reveal a round two question. Score is 4-3. 4-3 in favor of the champ. In favor of the challenger, Al. Oh.
Bless you.
Thank you. Al, you may have A or B.
Well, they say you should never switch skunks in the middle of the road. So,
Who says that?
I don't know. Somebody said,
said that.
Yeah. I'll try B. Okay.
You want B? Okay.
Before you read the card, I figured out how to play the game.
How?
If you write either tinkle, boobs, or made love, it'll match whatever you got.
Okay.
You read the card. I'll prove it to you.
Okay. Tell you what we're going to do.
I can't hear a dummy, but I'm not going out a dummy.
Before I read the question, write your answer.
Well, you got to give me a... I got three answers here. Tinkle, boobs, and made love.
All right.
Okay. Okay, go ahead. Read that. Right. I dare you now.
Now, listen to this. You know the terrible rash you get from just touching poison ivy?
Ooh.
Well, right. Harvey has an even worse rash. He got it from blanking poison ivy.
In this particular...
It doesn't work.
In this particular one... All three of them work.
You don't write. What? Just
who
Brett
writes?
And Joey,
give
that's all.
Again,
the terrible rash you got from just touching poison ivy, well, Harvey has an even worse rash. He got it from blanking poison ivy.
Hi, hon.
Hello there.
Oh, they're bananas.
Madam, you are a weirdo.
Oh, now who's that woman out there?
The lunatics have taken over the asylum.
That's right, they have.
We're gonna have to send Charles's nurse out to her.
I thought it was a woman. It's a man.
He's auditioning for the gong show.
Oh.
You
ready, Joey?
Huh?
Put in the slot.
Yes, sir.
Okay, here we go. Now, this is yours, Al. The terrible rash, you know about that, from just touching poison ivy. Well, Harvey has an even worse rash. He got it from blanking poison ivy.
Well, I heard Joey mention a couple of days ago on the show that this is a marijuana show.
Yeah.
A pot show. So I'll say smoking.
Smoking poison ivy. No, that was just a passing reference. What did you say? You say to that?
I don't have that, but it's not a bad idea.
Smoking poison ivy. What do you have?
Eating.
Eating is a good answer. Eating is a good answer. Brett?
I'm so deeply concerned about myself, I don't know what to do. I've begun to match Joey. I said eat it.
Eating. All right. Now, Muriel, what you have to do is match one to tie and two to win. Are you ready for this? Here we go. Vito said, the Godfather just asked me to go for a ride. And I'm really nervous because the Godfather isn't driving a car. He's driving a blank. You play, and you play. But not
I
you.
I don't play. Yes, you play. I don't play. I don't
you play.
You play.
Charles play.
That's nice. That's darling.
Okay.
Fold it toward you.
Good.
Too late.
All right. Hello, Muriel. Vito said the Godfather just asked me to go for a ride, and I'm really nervous because the Godfather isn't driving a car. He's driving a blank.
Machine gun. That was my second choice.
It appeared that it was a shoe-in for you.
That was my second choice.
But I think you've blown it. What was your first choice?
Hearse.
Well, certainly. Machine gun is her answer.
Oh, I thought she picked hearse.
No, she said hearse was her first choice, but she didn't say that.
I have hearse.
Hearse. Charles, what do you say? Hearse. Two hearses. Muriel, you've got to match Miss Lynn here to achieve a tie and stay in the game.
Oh,
it's up to you, my dear.
Sorry. Also, I'm sorry because on network television show, I'm illiterate. I misspelled it.
So, Al Walker wins the game. Congratulations. Now, you stand down there on the adhesive tape, okay? Muriel, want to shake your hand? You're a nifty lady, and you're going to leave here with $2,850. How does that grab you?
Thank you.
Good. Muriel Zlotnikoff, there she goes. Listen, I've got to ask you something now. There must be 20 or 30 people back there who all appear to be from Louisiana. Is that true? Are they all with you?
Well, actually, it's not 20 or 30, Gene. It's only 4 or 5, but each one make enough noise for 5 or 6 more. Yeah.
Are these the people who are with you down here?
That's right. That's my people with me.
And who are those people over there?
That's my people, too. I don't know them, but they're sure in my corner.
Well, they're really rooting for you, aren't they?
Mardi Gras is a little early.
Johnny, where are they from? Where are they from, John? Back there, that group back there.
Texas!
From Texas. And this is from they're from all over. All right, we got to stop right here now and do a little business with America, and then you hurry right back. I can hardly wait until next time when we're going to do the same thing all over again. Charles, anything you'd like to say about the Belle of Amherst, that wonderful thing starring Julie Harris?
Yeah, the play is going to play all over the country.
Yes.
From September to June.
Yeah.
And we're opening the last week in October in Washington.
Oh.
And when I was at the White House recently. No, Miss. Oh, true.
That's right. Charles was presented to the Queen of England at the White House.
We asked
recently.
The President and Mrs. Ford to please come.
Yes.
To please come. And he said, when is it? And we said, it's the last part of October we'll be in Washington. And he said, well, that's my busy time.
Yes, it is. All right. We'll look forward to seeing that. Join us next time for Match Game 76. Goodbye.